Hey guys, what's going on? Happy New Year. I'm here today to go over all the news that I missed out on releasing over the past couple days. I want to apologize before we actually start the video for that. I haven't made a video in a few days. I did do a live stream, I believe, on Friday or Saturday night, one of those two nights. I believe it was Saturday night, because that's when the Bleach Brave Souls banner went live. So, I want to apologize about the lack of videos. I've literally been deep diving into cryptocurrency. Like, if any of you were following me over on Twitter, you'd probably see a couple of the retweets that I posted out about some scams that are going on. At least for the coins that I'm looking into. But I'm looking into cryptocurrency. I started investing the end of November. Based off of what some of my coworkers are doing and things like that. A couple of friends and everything. So I decided to do a full deep dive into it to understand everything that's going on. All the different main branches, the different chains that are out there. How it works and which companies are coming out that look legitimate. Ones that are backed by big businesses. I literally did about 20 hours worth of research between Thursday night to Saturday, and I found a couple ones that I'm currently invested in, so I'm pretty happy with those investments. They're all long term, so like they're like a 3 to 5 year play out, so I have a long time to wait because they have a real lot of coins in circulation, but they look very promising. Outside of that, this is not going to turn into a cryptocurrency channel. I just wanted to let you all know that's what I did over this weekend, because I haven't been around. So let's go ahead and talk about everything. First off, shout out to the Reddit for all of this information, because I literally backtracked all 3 days worth of information outside the fluff through the Reddit. So we have a lot between both the JP and the global side. Guys, if I do miss anything, please let me know down in the comments below, because I honestly haven't even really logged into the game. I logged in the game once a day just to get my login rewards and to do the potential orbs. And that's really about it. And all the Dragonstone missions too. But outside of that, I really haven't done anything. I really get caught up with those quests because, by the way, if you don't know, part of the New Year's bonus on Global Side, I'm pretty sure JP2, is you have to do a whole bunch of quest missions. So I have to go and do about 50 of them by Wednesday. It's Tuesday, so tonight's going to be a grind. I might do a live stream tonight for that, by the way. So first off, first place achieved during the event period for the Global Side of Dokkan Battle. So it looks like this was, I don't know when this is exactly came out, but we came first in, so we're sending 20 plus 18 Dragonstones to all players. I think we got 18 for just the login bonuses, so we should still have this coming out. So stay tuned for that, make sure you log in daily and get all your rewards. The Google Play Store actually featured Dokkan Battle for all this information about Dragon Ball Z, so that's really awesome. The game is actually featured on the top. We might get a lot more downloads for that now, just because of the free marketing. Well, it's probably not free, but from all the marketing from Google Play, people will now know about this game. That is awesome. This might either be one of two things. It's either going to be a ploy because they're losing their player base, they're losing the amount of people who play, or they're doing so well, they said, you know what, let's market this even more because Dragon Ball Super is so hot right now. Either way, whatever they're doing, this is awesome for us in-game, because it means there's a lot more people who probably never knew about the game are now going to go in and start playing it. The next information is Hybrid Saiyan banner is live 1 day ago. GSSR 30 stones. Personally, I'm not a big fan of doing this. I mean, if you don't have any Hybrid Saiyans and you pulled the Gohan lead, some of them may be good. I know that that physical Gohan is really good. This Trunks, this Goten are cool. This Trunks actually, his passive activates guard to reduce, I believe, by 40% when his passive activates against, agility types, because I believe he is a technique type. So, if you get him and you're running up against, like, if we get that battle road thing where you go up against, like, extreme agility, things like that, and there's no actual reduction because you're bringing your super technique team, sorry for all that. He'd be really good because he will reduce a lot of damage. Anyway, these cards are really good. I think all of them are really cool, except for maybe this Gohan up over here on the top left. If you already have really good Hybrid Saiyans, then maybe not so much. They are good units. It's a good deal, and you get one featured SSR guaranteed, so that's really not that bad of a deal. It is a little bit of a stone burner. If you're looking for them, you want to try it out, it's a guaranteed SSR for 30 stones, so it's kind of worth if you want to throw in like 30 stones into it. If you're free to play, I either wouldn't recommend doing it at all, unless you really want to get a Hybrid Saiyan because your team, you have the ultimate Gohan, and you are lacking Hybrid Saiyan units. Anyway, it's a cool banner, I like it, I'm not going to summon it on myself, but it's there. The next one is 2018 login bonuses are out. That's about a day ago, so make sure you log in to claim those. You go in for your first time login, and you get 18 Dragonstones, 5 B18s, and man, she got those FME eyes. The 2018 Baba points and a whole bunch of friend points, which are kind of whack. So it looks like over here we do have, like, I guess it's like a big thank you. I just read through the comments. I was originally going to say it looks like a Dokkan Fest. It looks like it's just a big thank you. If you guys know anything about this outside of this one image, please let me know. But I did read through the comments, and it looks like we are over here, and it's just like, it's just a thank you. But we might be getting the Dokkan Awakening for Ultra Instinct Goku, so if there's any official information, please let me know down in the comments below. I literally just clicked this because I have to go into work really soon, so I wasn't able to do all the research I would like to. I plan on doing a whole bunch more videos of all the actual good information that's coming out. I'm going to go speak to a couple of my buddies who've been paying attention, so that way I can get you better and more official news. But if you guys know that what's going on with this, please let me know in the comments below. Elder Kai Banner is now live on the JP side. I think you get two multi-summons for 50 apiece, or for 20 total Elder Kais. I did one. I used up the rest of my stones, and I topped off all my other units, like Full Power Frieza, Super Saiyan 3 Bardock. And I did another, I think it was Kid Buu, Intelligence Kid Buu. I finished maxing them out. They're all Super Attack 10 now on the JP side, and I have some left over. Really worth it. Honestly, you should do at least one, so that way you can get some characters up to Super Attack 10, or at least get them up to Super Attack 5. New Year's special missions. Looks like this is just from global information about the special missions. Time limited, clear. Yeah, this is quest stage. You can do it up to 50 times, I believe, and you get a whole bunch of good rewards. And dailies are consume 18 stamina for one Dragon Stone. And outside of that, you don't really need to do anything else, but you're going to want to clear the quest stages and stuff like that. It goes along with a time-limited mission. So join me here tonight, because I'll probably be doing that on live stream. Supreme Kai Trials have been added as well to the global side of Dokkan Battle, so make sure you grind them out for the Patara Earrings. I didn't see them in the actual Baba Shop at this point. I didn't see them in either her treasures or anything else in there, so I don't know when they're actually going to come available. If you guys know, let me know in the comments below. I didn't read through the news. Translations in the comments. This is, looks like it's going to be for Beiteen, so let's go take a look at her. What is this? That login during period, get the Dragon Stones, blah, 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 blah. Yeah, so just log in and you get the Beiteen. She's a pretty cool card. I like those. That artwork is pretty nice. Next up is going to be the physical Gohan. His medal is going to be available on the Hero Extermination Plan. This is the physical Gohan. You can now Dokkan Awaken him. He's a really good support unit. He's available on level 13, Devastating True Power. You need 7 of these medals. So this is used to Dokkan Awaken both the physical and the intelligence Gohans. The physical Gohan's kind of whack before you Dokkan Awaken him. His passive skills, all allies attack plus 2,000 keys, 5 or more. But when you use those medals to Dokkan Awaken him, he actually becomes pretty freaking useful. His new passive skill, all allies attack and defense plus 35%. He's really good for a mono physical team and for a hybrid Saiyan team for support. Highly recommend getting those Awakening medals, even if you don't have them, just to play it safe. Next up is going to be new PLF Trove potential pack now gives 10 Christmas tickets. I don't recommend doing it at all, but if you guys want tickets, $20 for a potential orb pack, you also get 2 guaranteed SSRs for that banner. So, I mean, it's up to you if you think it's worth it, but it's 20. So essentially, it is $20 for a GSS, or for 2 GSSRs on the Christmas banner. You could do it. I mean, in terms of price per GSSR, it might be worth it for you, because it's only $10 per GSSR. And if you think about it, the stone packs that you buy in-game are more expensive for even the discounted rates of 30 stones for a GSSR. It might be worth it for you if you think you're going to get something good, but it's a GSSR ticket nonetheless. You know, you get one GSSR per $10, essentially, it comes out to. I'm not going to do it myself. You could do it, but you get potential orbs along with it. So, you know, it's up to you if you want to go ahead and purchase them. I don't recommend it, but if you guys do it, I hope you guys pull something good. And if you did it, let me know in the comments below what you guys pulled. LR Androids Legendary Campaign. Apparently, it was going to be coming to global soon. Pretty freaking awesome. Pretty interesting. Now, you know, I have a whole bunch of agility orbs, and now I'm going to have to go, once this comes out, I'm going to have to go and awaken them or get them up to 100%. I already have the LR Android Super Attack 20 with all 4 dupes unlocked. Now I'm just going to go ahead and, you know, fill them out once that comes to global. Top grossing orbs and gift box for JP, so go ahead and grab those orbs if you haven't already done so. That's about 4 days ago. I'm getting into the really old news right now. We also got, I guess this was a problem. I know a lot of people were talking about this. I think I was doing a live stream when this actually happened. JP got a full refund because the card art for the Broly was messed up. So anyone who put orbs or Dragon Stones into the banner got all of them refunded. Don't really know how I feel about that, but I mean, hey, if you're a JP player, good on you. New Year celebration. We have all this information over here. It looks like everything's pretty much live except for these two events, which is the Warriors of Universe 6 summons, Universe 6 Saga story event, and a new Threat Saiyan Warrior Race story event returns. So this Universe 6 stuff will be coming on January 6th, so stay tuned for that. That's going to be pretty awesome. The Warriors of Universe 6 summons, anyway. It's GSSR multi, so that's pretty legit. The Hidden Potential Orbs are available every day, 3x quest. Fight Against Despair, which is cool because you grind out the Trunks to increase the Rage Trunks super attack if you want to go through that grind. Supreme Kai Trials, we already mentioned. We already mentioned the New Year stuff, so you have all that information in the Dokkan Festival for the SDR Ultimate Gohan. And outside of that, I think we're almost done here. Double Dokkan Fest now live on JP. You get this is with the Vegito Blue and Rose. These are really good banners. If you guys looked, I did do the Rose banner summons on camera with you guys. Outside of that, guys, that's it. That's all the information that I'm aware of that happened over the weekend while I have not been making videos. Again, I really apologize about that. I just really need to look into crypto and, you know, get a good foothold and understanding of what's going on and find what I want to do with it. Also, for those of you who are interested, who have made it this far, thank you for staying tuned this long. I just want to let you all know, on Bleach Brazels, something told me yesterday, do a multi-summon. I'm sitting there, and I'm just like, something in my gut's really trying to push me to do a multi-summon, and I did a multi-summon, and I got her. For those of you who know who her is, oh my god. Level 200, ridiculous. Anyway, guys, I'll be doing a live stream probably later on tonight, and I will go over that more in depth as well. Anyway, guys, thank you for joining me here today. Make sure to subscribe if you're new. I'll catch you all later. Peace.